fucking messages. Can't they just leave me alone? Every day, every fucking day. In and out, someone is fucking bothering me. My mum, my brother, my boss. Have they not got the message yet? Man, I look like shit this morning. What the hell was I up to last night? I remember walking into a club and that's about it. Well, after 8 pints, 7 shots and a double absinthe, what do you expect? I leave the house every night, a simple online PA and return a lucky man. How rude of me, I haven't introduced myself yet. My name is Oscar. Oscar Lawton. I was living that fucking high life. Each night I'd be bringing back a bird, or sometimes even two. I mean, yeah, I still live with my mum, but if I couldn't hear us going at it, then why would it matter? Oh, what's that you say? I'm arrogant. Sorry, you're gonna have to write that down for me to understand. See, that's the thing, guys. I had already tried to make an effort in this sick world, but no one ever understood me. Either they would walk away or just dismiss me like I was shit underneath their shoe. My whole life was a joke, so why not just embrace that? Exactly. There was one thing that kept me from tying a rope around my neck and ending it all. And that one thing was Rosetta Mayne. She was this girl who worked at the local pub as a waitress, not so much to show for her talent, but my, she was mighty fine. And she wasn't the typical stuff-up glamour bitch I usually go for. She had something. She just had something. And she was the only girl I did not feel confident with. I'd come down here, day in, day out. I felt the creep following her, always spying, but I was just waiting for my opportunity. My chance to talk to her, ask her out. But I just didn't know how. I mean, like, you know what typical guys, girls go for. The macho, arrogant twat, who always fucks and pleases. But I know she didn't want that. It was all I'd ever been. But even if I had the shittiest day ever, I'd think of her, then it would all be okay. It was March 7th, my birthday. It was a Sunday and I was feeling lucky. I'd walk up to her, give her some flowers and I'd just picked and then ask her for a date. I mean, yeah, of course I was nervous, but I didn't want a chance to be missed. Here it goes. Three weeks went by, and she hadn't appeared once. I'd missed my chance, you know, the one fucking day I would have fucking done it is the day I fuck up. She'd gone, and I was never gonna see her again. A few more weeks passed by, and by this time I'd given up. I'd missed my chance, and I wasn't getting it back. If only I'd taken it, then I would be living in the hellhole I was living in now. I was drinking a litre of JD every night, accompanied by 2 cans of Pepsi and 4 packs of Walkers. Yet again, I was living the fucking high life. What did I become? You know, maybe it was only just a girl. Maybe I was overreacting. It was time for a change. She was just a girl who could have changed a pressing little scrawny fuckwit like me. Was it a miracle? Was I so doped out of my mind that I was just imagining this? Oh, my breath stank like shit, but I couldn't waste this chance. When out, guys. I guess there is hope in this world after all.